make our way down to a child's pose. We're gonna start this day off real slow and steady and controlled, all right? Making your way down to that child's pose. Like I said, we're gonna use the full 45 minutes today, pretty much. We're gonna start off this workout real slow. And maybe that's because I just played a full game of pickleball, and I was just shooting around a basketball for the first time in a decade, maybe 2 decades. And I'm a little winded this time. I'm just kidding, I had this plan from the start. So we're in that child's pose right now. Taking that breathing nice and deep. I want you to take 5 breaths in this child's pose. You're probably right around that third or fourth breath already. So just take one more real deep inhale. And an exhale, you let out any negative thought that you had carrying your feet this week, through this day. Exhale it out. Now we flow forward to a baby up dog. I want to take 5 breaths here as well. Turn the elbows towards the rib cage, letting the hips drop down towards the ground. And then just pressing up that whole upper body up away from the ground. Yoga is bending one way, then the other. You have the front side of the body closed off from that child pose. Now we want to open up that front side of the body from this baby up dog. It's comfortable. Upward facing dog here. Take another breath by looking over your left shoulder, and as you do, you'll feel that right hip lengthen a little bit. We'll take our final breath in this pose, looking over that right shoulder and allowing that left hip to lengthen. Now we come to a neutral tabletop position. Knees right under my hips, hands right under my shoulders. Cat cows is what we look for now, but I want very slow moving. On my inhale, I drop my pelvis and look forward. On my exhale, I round my back and look down between my legs. 5 breaths, so that's 5 cat cows. Your next inhale, you look forward. Your next exhale, you round that back and look back behind you. Moving according to your own breath, so it might not align perfectly with mine, and that's okay. One more. Inhale, exhale, drop that pelvis. Push back to a downward facing dog for the first time now. I'm on the balls of my feet, my hips are the highest point of my body, my head is just hanging between my biceps. And I find some stillness for the first 3 breaths here. Again, just focusing on all things positive, letting the negative thoughts of snow and mark outside swim out from between the ears, let some positive thoughts, some positive vibes, some positive intentions come into your thought process. Staying in this downward facing dog, I want you to allow your right knee to bend as your left heel comes down towards the ground. Stay on this side for a full breath, in through the nose, out through the mouth. Same thing on that other side now. That right heel comes down towards the ground, that left knee is bent. Inhale, exhale, let it all out. Walk those feet up to the hands. I wanna land into a ragdoll position. I want you to cross your arms so that your fingertips are on the opposite elbows. And again, I want you to release all that tension that you can out to the top of your head. No tension to the back of the neck, the shoulders. The whole upper body is just laying down and relaxing here. Bringing some attention to the backside of not just that lower body, but that lower back might feel a stretch, that upper back might feel a stretch. The more you sink into it, the more you'll feel where your body needs you to feel. Release those arms, let them hang down towards the ground. Stay here for an additional couple of breaths. My fingertips are right down by my toes. I'm gonna shift my weight over to my left leg. I'm gonna shift over to my left leg. You feel that stretch through my left hamstring. Now same thing over that right side. Come back to neutral. One vertebrae at a time with the back now. I want you to slowly inch to rising, letting the shoulders hang and letting the head be the last thing to come up from standing. Bring the arms up,
Get the body as tall as it can get now. I want to stay here, root to reach. Getting those fingertips engaged, those arms engaged over the shoulders, those hips slightly forward, if anything, so that your body is as long as it can possibly be right here. Feel both those arms now by turning the palms facing forward, bending the elbows so that they come down in line with the shoulders or even a little bit lower than the shoulders. Those hips are forward. Inhale here, exhale, go back to that root to reach before cutting that body in half and sweeping those shoelaces. Coming to a flat back for the first time, my hands are right onto my upper shins, my back is flat, my neck is neutral. Step back to a high plank and hold that high plank for as long as we've been holding these other positions now. Those first positions that we hold feel good when we hold them. Now for this five breath hold, it gets a little bit of tension, a little bit of stillness and some strength through not just the upper body, but the lower body as well. And the only way that that happens is if you engage the glutes, engage the hamstrings. My elbows are turned slightly towards each other to take the pressure off my shoulders, because we'll get plenty of pressure on those shoulders. One more deep breath, holding this high plank in through the nose, out through the mouth. Inching forward and then all the way down to the ground. Relaxing down here on the ground. We're going to make our way back to that child's pose for the second time now. Knees are wide, hips are back over the heels. We find that stillness in that child's pose, but this time everything is only held for a breath. In through the nose, out through the mouth, release all that tension once again. In through the nose, as we exhale, we come forward to that baby up dog. Let those hips drop down, elbows towards the rib cage, looking forward or even looking up. Inhale here, exhale, push back to that downward facing dog. Stick that downward facing dog for a breath. Now take a breath to travel those feet up to the hands by walking those feet up step by step. Inhale, come halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come all the way up to that root to reach, landing into that baby back bend at the top. That's going to be our flow now. Up we come, we sweep the shoelaces, flat back. Step back to that high plank. Like everything else, we only hold it for a breath. In through the nose, out through the mouth, we stay here. In through the nose, out through the mouth, it's that slow moving chaturanga. We come down and then up through that upward facing dog. Pushing back to that downward facing dog. Walking those feet up to the hands. Coming halfway up to that flat back, hands on the knees. Fold forward. All the way up and open. One more time for that whole progression. Up we go. Sweep the shoelaces, flat back. High plank. Low plank. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Travel those feet up to the hands. Flat back. Pull forward. All the way up and over. From here, we root to reach. We sweep those shoelaces flat back. Step back to that high plank, to that low plank, to that upward facing dog. Back to that downward facing dog. Now raise your right leg up. Heel that right hip open. By stacking the hips and allowing that top right knee to bend generously 90 degrees before stepping that right foot to the right hand for warrior one here. My right foot is on the right side of my mat. My left foot is on the left side of my mat. My arms are up. Coming down, stepping right back to that downward facing dog. Left leg comes up, heels open, we hold it for a breath. And we step that left foot to the left hand. A warrior one on this other side. Sink down deep into it if you can. Hands come down. Back to that downward facing dog. Walk those feet up to the hands. Land into a flat back. Fold forward. From here, we come right into a chair pose. Picking those hips back. Sticking them down a bit. Tail end of this yoga flow warm up. Just about sticking these positions now one more time through. Sink down just a little bit more, hold it. Cut the body in half at the hips, sweep those shoelaces, come back to that flat back, hands and knees. Shut around the high, the low plank. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Bring the feet close together in the back now, tail end of this warm up, I promise. Downward facing dog with those feet close. Right leg comes up, tails open, and steps into that warrior two right down the center of your mat. Arms are up and parallel to the ground. From here, I want to come to that extended side angle, right forearm to that front right quad. Left side of the body is extended and open and long through the fingertips. Keeping the integrity of the legs, not moving the legs at all. Reverse that warrior. Left hand down the side, the back side of the body. Right arm up. Cartwheel the hands down. Push right back to that downward facing dog. Feet are still together and back. Now we raise that left leg up. Heel those hips open. And step that left foot between the hands for warrior two on that other side. Stick it nice and low. Arms parallel with the ground. Extended side angle, left forearm to that left quad. Right arm is up. Feel that right hip engage. Legs don't move at all. Upper body reverses that position. Left arm up, right hand slides down. The back side of that right leg. Cartwheel the hands down, downward facing dog. Land down onto the hands and knees. We are ready to get moving now. Grabbing our dumbbells, ready for some endurance-based strength training. That means only two exercises per circuit that we do. The first exercise that we're gonna start off with is going to be some skull crushers from down flat on our back. Skull crushers is that tricep extension from laying down flat, all right? Is that okay with you, Amelia? Two thumbs up if that's okay. Is that good? All right,
two thumbs up, Amelia. We're gonna start off with those skull crushers, those nose breakers.
30 second timer is gonna keep us honest tonight, because I'm gonna lose track of time. I'm gonna be dunking the basketball and stuff, showing you guys that I should be in the NBA. But 30 seconds timer is gonna keep us honest. 30 seconds of nose breakers, starting it up in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Hinge out those elbows.
Let the weights come down slightly overhead. Extend those weights right back up. 15 reps is what you're looking for here. Squeezing the tricep with every rep.
On that 15th rep, you can let the weights down somewhere they're easy to get, probably by your hips, so that you can come up to a seated position. For some kick outs here. My hands are behind me for support, my legs are up, my legs come out, and then right back. Nice and slow this first time. I want you to think about being in a high boat if you're in a yoga class, and a low boat. Come back to my pace now. High boat, low boat, high boat, row, row, row your boat. Back and forth we go. And we are back to those nose breakers, those skull crushers overhead, hinging at the elbows, extending those weights up. Well, the 15 reps,
30 seconds, feet are flowing down.
Thank you.
Slow this up. Break your left, left to right. Break your left, left to right. Stay on your knees. Now, keep that knee up once again. Let's go.
Three sets down. What's better than three is four. Four is the final set on those nose breakers. Grab those hips.
Let's see. Let's see.
Nine to three leg raises is our last exercise.
The first circle, like nice and slow. Down, one, two, three, up one. Down, one, two, three, up two. All 30 seconds of it. Slow takes the start. Last 10 seconds, I want you to get 20 reps in this again. Right now, let's go up and down. We go, come on. All the way through the 11.
Whoa. 4 minutes of work and just 30 seconds recovery. And in that 30 seconds, we're going to make our way up to standing. Standing bicep curls is what we are coming back to here. Grabbing those weights and getting ready to go. Ready to rock and roll. Same idea. Endurance phase and strength training. 15 reps for 30 seconds and it all starts. Right now, heart open, palms forward. No swing of those hips, no swing of those upper arms. Focus on that core, on the form, right out of the gate. Feels a lot longer than 20 seconds of jumping jacks. Three, two, one, let's do it. team here. It's a burnout in this last set. Four sets all around today. Getting a little bit of something extra out of every circuit we come through. And our last 20 seconds of work is going to be that low impact burpee, where we just stick that high plank at the bottom. Wide feet at the top. Stay tall. Even if you're modifying, you can step back to a high plank, then step up to standing. But it's 20 seconds regardless, and we are gone. Done. Very good. 40 seconds recovery. We'll be coming back to some shoulder focused movement. We got a shoulder press coming up next. Woo, baby. They had a cat, the DJ, the host today. She's hosting me for the workout. That's what we get all these bright lights for. To Karen. To Karen. Let's go.
All right, shoulder press. Grab those weights. Ready, set.
Let's get it right here. Split stance.
15 reps. Should take you less than 30 seconds. And that is what we're looking for.
Billy's looking for me. I know she is.
15 reps. And coming down onto our backs. Seat though. I know elbow. See that exercise is coming up. My pace. Need to be here for support. Crunch to the top. Extend it and out of the bar. Crunch and hold. Extend and hold. High foot. Low boat, high boat, low boat, and now we roll that boat basically quick to the end of that round. 30 full seconds of our core work, cutting into that shoulder press. We are ready for that shoulder press.
Ready, set, let's go, 15. Instead of those kick outs, the high boat, that low boat, we come down for our flutter kicks. Flutter kicks, 90 degrees between it. Ready, set, let's go. Flutter kicks, slow first. Left leg up, right leg up. Left up, right up. My pace, stay here. Now we go quick in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Left, right. Shoulder press, let's pop up and get to it. Come on, 15.
Here we go. Now we go.
Slowing down here, I am. Whew. I'm getting cooked, and so is my Wi-Fi team, but I've been with you so far. You guys seem like you're with me still.
I'm gonna keep going. Over here, man. I need a good workout sometimes, too. Bent over tricep extensions are coming back. We got bent over tricep extensions. Second tricep movement of the night, and it starts right now. Let's do it. Hinge at the hips. Elbows are up. They stay up as we press back. Remember, we're not curling forward. These aren't hammer curls. We will get there if you haven't guessed it yet. But right now, we're all about that press back. 15 reps. Letting those weights down. Jumping jacks, 20 seconds only. Already started. Let's go. Good, grabbing those dumbbells. Back and ready, back bent over tricep extension again. 15 reps for 30 seconds. We are back to grip right now. Let's go. Extensions, two sets of them down. Extend those weights back behind you. Three, six, coming back for the rest of our way, the rest of our workout. Our first complex movement is going to be a hammer curl to a neutral grip
shoulder press here. We come down here, here, back down. All
right? Get the curl press.
And that shoulder press is neutral grip.
Ready, set, let's go. Curl, press. Catch those legs, finish that curl. Don't forget to be shoulder space on the way down. Basically a three-part movement. Curl, shoulder press, bottom half of that curl. We gotta get through that effort. One more time. High ball, hold it. Wait for everyone to catch up. Low ball, hold it. High ball, hold it. Low ball, cover over the ground. Nice and quick now. Up to that curl of breast complex. Biceps and shoulders getting our work done this circuit. Curl, press. All the way through that buzzer. It's 30 seconds of leg work, 30 seconds of ab work. Flutter, kicks, coming down to it. And slow through with the start, slow moving. Slow and steady. Ready to get that legs up. Nice and quick, but still control right now. Let go. Two sets to go. Curl press. Come on. That's right. Four sets of everything. There, makes a change of the game off this leg. Four sets all around. That's what we're looking for. That's what we started with. That's what we're finishing with. Bicycle crunches, slow and spin. Right elbow to left knee, left elbow to right knee. Off feet, but slow and move. Quick work for our last 15. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Back and forth. Three sets down. Fourth and final. Curl the press. Let's do it. Come on. Shoulders failing. Biceps failing. 90-degree leg raises, you should close down a quick circuit here. Down slow, up slow. Control through everything. And fast, that fast. Five to 10 reps, let's go. Flexing by the name of the game. You spike something in the spot I'm tasting like. Parents trying to get the elbow laid after this. I don't know. Maybe it's just a plastic cup. I'm tasting some Doc and Gill cutters in here or something. Might be meeting at L Street Tavern after this one if anyone wants to take the trip over. Woo! Complexes are the name of the game. We're going to be in a push-up position. Our complex is going to be a three-part movement, kind of like it was in that first one. It's going to be a push-up followed by a one-arm row, but with a tricep extension from that one-arm row position, from that high plank position. Two options for it. I'll show you both of them. The first one is the more difficult one, so if you need to resort away from it, that's fine. But it's a high plank, and it's one push-up to a one-arm row, extension, and that other side, row, extension. Back down for a push-up and start it up again. Now you can do that off your knees if you need to. From your knees, push-up. Then you have the choice to either travel up to the high plank for that row or stay here. Row, extension. Row, extension. All right? We're going to go for 20 seconds only on this because it's going to be a tough transition. I'll shoot you straight right out of the gate here. We're going to mix in all four of those towels once again. Jumping jacks. Mountain climbers. Running in place. Burpees. But that's going to be a tough transition because, like I said, we're going to be coming from this high plank for all four of those. Really tough. So it's 20 seconds on, 10 seconds to recover. 10 seconds till we go down. One more shot to get you going. Really good. There's something wrong with it. It reads cups or something. No, no, no. Nice gym, but they're cheaping out on me. I'm kidding. Thanks for having me. All right, ready? Push up. Row extension. Row extension. Push up. Start this off again. Come through it as many times as you can in 20 seconds. Like I said, it's only 20 seconds of work. We'll have 10 seconds to recover, and that first 10 seconds starts now. Land down onto the hands and knees. Gently make your way up to standing. And it is jumping jacks as our recovery. And it starts right from here. That gives us 10 seconds to get back down into position to start up that strength complex once again. We go push up to row and extension. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Another rep or two. Land down into that child's pose. You can keep the weights right where they are. It actually helps you out by having your hands raised for your mountain climbers. Believe me. Takes the pressure off the hips. Mountain climbers, you're a tumor. Come on. To recover, I told you it's a tough transition here. It's basically staying in a high plank for a minute and a half straight. When we come back to it now, let's go push up, row extension, row extension, push up again. Ah. 10 seconds to get up to standing. Woo, baby! Tail end of this workout. Just running in place or running around your house. Whatever you need right now. Move around. Yeah! Oh. Keep moving. Keep those feet moving. Keep those arms loose. Ah! Last set of the day, last minute of the day. We are ready to go. That complex push up to row and extension. Let's do it. Done with that strength work once again. Our last 20 seconds of the day is going to finish us off with those low impact burpees. Let's do it now. Let's see it. High plank for the bottom. Wide feet stand tall. Time. And
that is all I got for you guys today. Unless I dunk this basketball right now.
I don't worry. Oh, my God. For a long time, I think I'm the only 5'9" guy in the history of the world that can dunk. That's all it is. That's what happened. Now I've only 5 minutes. Let's see it.
Where's he going, Amelia? Yay! He dunked it.
Now 45.
Hi, Amelia.
Get out of here, guys. Good work.
Hi.
Great job, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming out as usual.
Thank you.
Good work, guys.
Hi, Amelia.
Hi. Did you have a good workout?
Amelia, did you have a good workout?
You have fun?
Yeah.
How did Mama do, Amelia? What's up, Archie? Did Mama do good?